Yo, what's up guys? It's Pygos here, the Crypto Pi, and today we're going to be talking about patience, guys, right? Because it's a huge, I'd say, quality that you need to have in order to trade successfully, alright? So patience, guys, alright? It's something big, alright? Whether your patience is on the 15-minute chart, 5-minute chart, 1-hour, 4-hour, daily, I don't care. Alright, for all of the time frames, you will need patience. So, for example, let's take a look on the 1-hour, right? So in my Telegram group, people are, you know, constantly asking me, should I get in already, you know, for maybe a little bounce? Well, if that is your plan, then you should, right? But while you have the patience, guys, you plan out a trade before you get into it, right? So it's something you just need to be aware of. And some people tell me as well, like, why did you take your profit so early on Ontology? That's not patient, right? Well, it's still, I had patience, right? I entered the trade and my plan was just to take small profits. It's just how my plan was. Because at the moment, you just don't know whether Bitcoin will fall or not, right? So it's just a big quality that you need to have. I don't think it's just in trading. I think it's in a lot of things in life, right? You need to have patience, guys. So just be patient enough to wait for your entry. Right now, even though I have this planned out, right, like the ABC, and perhaps it will play out, I told myself I'm not entering at this 382. It's too dangerous, right? I'm patiently waiting in between this 0.5 and 618 area. If it goes below 0.65 and closes below, I'm out, all right? It's just the way I have my trade plan set up. And I think you guys should do the same, right? Just have a trade plan, and then once it gets to your entry, don't be scared, just put in your money, right? Because you're already, if you did it right, in your trade plan, you also have where you will get yourself stopped out, and you know how much you can lose potentially, right? And you also know how much you can gain, right? So for example, for me, what I can see happening, as much as I don't like head and shoulders, I'm well aware it could happen, right? Is that we go down to 618 or 0.5 anywhere in here, then what I'm targeting, guys, is just up here. I'm not targeting anything more, right? So how much is that? About 10%, once again. It's a small percentage, I know, but I'm not targeting more. And I know it could potentially be a very big three run. But guess what, guys? If it's a big three run, there will always be pullbacks within that run as well. So if I see the market's very bullish, I can always jump in again. I'm just patient. I know I have my plan set out. If I take that 10% trade and it's successful, I know how much I'm making. I know how much I'm going in with. Full disclosure, I'm going in with $8,000. So if I make 10%, that would be $800, right? And I'm not going in with all of my capital. No, I don't do that. You might have to. All right, so a lot of people tell you never to go all in. Well, I don't agree. Because when I was very small still, right? If you only have $1,000, guys, and you want to make at least some money, you almost have to go all in, right? You almost have to. Because if you just say like, oh yeah, I'm going in with like 20% of my capital, then you will not make a lot, right? So I think it's more to the people that have a lot of money, they cannot go all in, all right? So guys, patience is something that you need to have, and also risk management, right? So that is the two things that you need to have in order to become a successful trader. I don't think you even need, I mean, it's really good to know all the technical know-how. That's why I make all these videos for you guys. But if you look carefully, I do the same thing over and over and over again, right? I just take my Fibonacci. Right now we had a 5 run according to me. Maybe you don't agree, but I think this was a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, and then a 5. This is Ontology, guys. So what I do is I take the Fibonacci from the bottom to the top. Where do I aim to enter? It just like always, guys, just like always, right? In between the 0.5 and the 618. This is my enter area, right? If we stretch that out a little bit to the left, we can see that that's also 0.4. Now, That is often where the wave 2 goes. Not always. I'm well aware that it can also go to 786. Why do I stop myself out between, you know, when it drops, when it closes below 6.5? Well, that is because just to preserve capital, guys, right? I just preserve capital with that. And I know that a wave 2 can even go to 886 as long as it doesn't make a new low. But I'm not waiting that much. That's a crazy risk, right? So that is just my plan, guys. And I always trade the same, right? As boring as it might be, I always trade the same way. And I think that's also where the chance of profitability and just losing outright lays. You always got to do the same thing, right? Once you find a strategy that works over the longer term, you just always have to do the same thing, even though it's boring. Why am I not taking this A to B? Simply because I've done this before, and from results, I see that, you know, there's a chance as well that it just keeps dropping and it doesn't even do this. So, well, maybe this was already an A, B, C, right? We don't know. So, it's very hard to know that. And anyone who tells you they know exactly that was already an A, B, C, you just don't. So, yes, it could very well bounce up here. But you also see that the EMAs are already kind of bending downwards, right? So, that's just something, guys, patience, right? So let's take a look at just some other markets, right? Let's go look at Bitcoin, right? Once again, guys, I think that this was the top. So what do? I take this Fibonacci from the bottom to this top. Where do I think, if I potentially want to get in on Bitcoin right now, right? With some leverage, on some leverage longs, since I missed the short because I play Binance. That's another thing, guys. You should always look at multiple exchanges, right? Remember, we didn't hit that, if we take the Fibonacci, right? We didn't hit that negative 236 from this high. So let me just take that real quick, right? So if we take this bottom here, we take this top, we never hit that. But that's by exchange, right? If we type in BTCUSD, and we go to Bitstamp, right? Bitstamp in this case was correct because we had this one and then basically it hit it. Let me see here. Where is it? So if we take this, see? So there we go. Negative 236 was hit. So it depends on what exchange you're looking at. So that means the shorting opportunity is already gone in my eyes, right? Because we're not in a very bullish market. I didn't think we would hit the negative 618, really. I mean, it's a possibility, but I honestly thought we wouldn't. But simply because we didn't hit that negative 236 yet on Binance, then I thought, like, okay, so maybe we'll overshoot it next time and go all the way to negative 618. But now I see that on Bitstamp, we already hit it. So naturally, people, they probably didn't go short all the way up there. I mean, you need to be, that's a very risky way, but they probably did somewhere around here, right? When they saw these wicks, they went short and they're in a short position right now, and they're probably targeting down all the way like somewhere down, right? Let's take a look where they're targeting, guys. So they went from this top, right, from this top to this bottom, and then they have this 0.5. They hit that, right? They hit that. So right now they're short, and they be targeting negative 236 around this $5,500 area. Once again, 53, 54, 55, something around there, right? That's what they're targeting. Maybe they will front run it. Who knows? This is on Bitstamp, so that's the way they're trading it, most likely, right? The ones who went short. And they need to have patience for it to drop there. Now, if they see any kind of reversal, they'll probably close their short and take their profit. So it's just multiple ways. So always look at multiple exchanges. That's something that I learned. So you learn every day, guys. I need to look at more exchanges because the negative 236 was already hit. And I would have been in a short now as well if I knew that. But I didn't. So I didn't go into a short. So guys, what am I targeting here on Bitcoin? Well, the same thing, right? The right around here, the 0.5618. All right, so where do I say I'm wrong if it closes below the 6.5? It's just the same strategy over and over and over again. Do I take a trade right now? No. Why? Because I have a system, right? I buy in between the 0.5 and the 6.18 at the moment. If we're super bullish, you need to be able to adjust as well, right? If we're super bullish again in a super bull month, then I might be targeting 382. It depends on what the market shows me, like what happens more often than not. But for now, I'm only targeting 0.5 to 6.18. So, guys, patience is something that you need to just get used to, right? I mean, you might get lucky in some of these swings, like 382 a little bit up and then take a little bit profit. Yeah, that could happen. But if you target these areas, your probability goes up at the moment because we're kind of still in a bearish market, and you will see bigger retracements, right? All the way to 0.5618. So yeah, that's just how it is. So let's take a look at Ethereum, right? We take this bottom, take this top, right around there. It's at the 6.18 right now, right? Did it close below the 6.5? Yes, it did, but only barely, right? So here it's kind of like a doubting case. You'll doubt yourself for a little bit, so you let the next candle go for a bit, and you see that it goes up. So, you know, could you buy this right now? Yes, you can. But keep in mind, so this is another thing, keep in mind that when you play altcoins like Ethereum or Ontology or whatever, you need to look at Bitcoin as well, and Bitcoin is still not done retracing, not in my opinion. Right, because this one also needs to go to the 0.5 to 6.18 area. That's just how I play it, right? And the people who went short here, they're looking at this area to take profit. And if it falls through, they'll be, you know, if they play it right, they'll be patient. And if it gets lower than the 6.5, closest below, it's most likely gonna make a new low, right? And they'll hit that 5,500 target, and then they will close their short. And perhaps it will cascade down to my target of about 5,300, you know, where I think a big bounce will happen. But guys, patience is just something very important, all right? So that's pretty much what this whole video was about, guys. Just patient, all right? Just be patient. On Ontology, I'm very patient. I'm waiting for the market to go down to the 0.5 to 6.18 area, and I'll certainly fill up the boat right there, depending on how Bitcoin's behaving, right? So if Bitcoin's also bouncing a little bit, then of course I'll be filling up the boat, because then my probability of it going back up is high, right? Then we have basically a 1, 2, and then we're gonna get a 3, 4, 5, right? So and then all I'm targeting, guys, once again, is just maybe this is gonna be a head and shoulders, right? Even though I'm not a big fan of the pattern, I'm well aware it's there. So guys, that's how I play it, right? I'm waiting for the 0.5 to 6.18. So it's that simple, and I keep playing the same strategy over and over and over again. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. And of course, there's a lot of more stuff going on, right, with the whole RSI divergence and all that. But this is the basic of the strategy, and that is the meat of my strategy, right? It's just to buy in between the 0.5 and 6.18. Now, of course, if it shows me bearish RSI divergence, then I will not go in. But if you just play this and you don't even know about that, you will still make money overall. All right, trust me on that. So, yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. All right. So, also, if you're not in my Telegram yet, join up with the CryptoPies blog, where you can ask me any questions, you can ask other people questions. It's just a great chat box to be in, right? John, I'm asking, you know, I'm answering all John's questions here. Just there's a lot of chat here as well about hash puppies. That's like I love that. I'm gonna get a hash puppy, guys, so that's cool. Then there's so much chat here, right, guys? So there was also an airdrop being talked about by ICO Moon Tracker, of course. You know, he always talks about those, so that's great, guys. You know, try to get in on those. It's just free money, so just get in. All right, so yeah, join up with that, guys. Also, join up with the CryptoPies feed, where I post all my videos, post about upcoming ICOs, so you whitelist for them, right? And you're ready for the sale when it's there, and you won't miss out, simple as that. Unless you're from the US or Canada or China, they're often not allowed. So Yeah, you just have to kind of look at if you're allowed in or not. But hey, I can't help that. So anyways, guys, both telegrams will be in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Hit that post notification button. And if you've got any questions at all, leave a comment below. And I'll see you guys in the next video.